I am the king, and I have snakes on my shoulders. It's not fun anymore. After 700 years, Iran descended from the heights of civilization back into a dark age. Here's the solution to Sinus. Yeah, he actually wanted people to swear that he was the best king ever. I will not testify, said Kaveh the blacksmith. خروشید و برجست لرزان زجای بدرید و بسپرد مقصد به پای. Everyone was shocked. How did Zahak let him be so rude? Zahak answered, I don't know. که چون کاوه آمد ز درگه پدید دو گوش من آواز او را شنید میان من و او ز ایوان درست تو گفتی یکی کوه آهن برست. Outside the palace, کاوه had started a battle. همی بر خروشید و فریاد خواند جهان را سراسر سوی داد خواند. He raised his leather apron on a spear as a flag and summoned people. خروشان همی رفت نیزه به دست که ای نامداران یزدان پرست کسی کو هوای فریدون کند سر از بند ضحاک بیرون کند. Kaveh knew Fereydun's place. He headed to the Elbrus mountain, people following him. فریدون چو گیتی بدان گونه دید جهان پیش ضحاک وارونه دید. Fereydun was so excited when he saw the flag. He decorated it with precious fabrics and jewels. فروهشت از او سرخ و زرد و بنفش همی خواندش کاویانی درفش. Everyone added something to that ragged flag. ز دیبای پرمایه و پرنیان بدان گونه شد اختر کاویان که اندر شب تیره خورشید بود جهان را از او دل پر امید بود. Fereydun had two older brothers. As he ordered, they made him a mace with a cow-like head. It looked like the cow that once had been a mother to Fereydun. He assured his brothers, که گردون نگردد به جز بر بهی به ما باز گردد کلاه مهی. Fereydun took over the job from this spot and they headed to the city. همی رفت منزل به منزل چو باد سری پرز کینه دلی پرز داد. Of course, there were some obstacles in the way, like river guards who needed Zahak's permission to let them pass. They didn't give a ship to Fereydun, so he taught them a lesson with his mace and hit the water on his horse. People did the same. They finally got to the castle. Fereydun opened the door with his mace, but Zahak wasn't there. He fought the guards and found the women. برون آورید از شبستان اوی بوتان سیه موی خورشید رو بفرمود شستن سرانشان نخست روانشان از آن تیرگی ها بشست. He told them his story and his plan. Arnavaz was excited. بدو گفت شاه فریدون تویی که ویران کنی تنبل و جادویی. We've been captives here for 1,000 years. همی جفت من خاند و جفت مار چگونه توان بود ای شهریار. They told him that Zahak was not doing well. In search of a cure, he was traveling from one country to another, and now he was in India. Fereydun was restless. سرش را بدین گرزه گاف چهر بکوبم نه بخشایش آرم نه مهر. Though he'd killed the guards, the castle wasn't empty yet. The king's confidant was a man named Kondro, who didn't show any resistance against Fereydun. So the new king ordered him to throw a feast with everyone who deserved to celebrate liberty. جهان هفت کشور تو را بنده باد سرت برتر از ابر بارنده باد. He said this and headed toward India. He said everything to Zahak and he just couldn't believe his ears. Oh, so we have a guest. What kind of guest is that? He's sitting on your throne, throwing parties at your palace. Oh, so we have a rude guest. I'll talk to him when I go back. He just couldn't accept until Kondro said, okay, what if I tell you he's stealing your wives? This time, he lost his temper and marched towards Iran with his troop. On the other hand, سپاه فریدون چو آگه شدند همه سوی آن راه بیره شدند همه در هوای فریدون بودند که از درد ضحاک پرخون بودند. Everyone fought with everything that they had. ز دیوارها خشت و ز بام سنگ به کوی اندرون تیغ و تیر و خدنگ. نخواهیم برگاه ضحاک را مران اژدها دوش ناپاک را. But Zahak didn't think he was serious. He thought, I'll kill the boy with my own hands, and it'll be over. از آن شهر روشن یکی تیره گرد برآمد که خورشید شد لاژورد. Zahak entered the palace covering his face with armor. He saw the women sitting next to Feridun. And Shahnaz, دو رخسار روز و دو زلفش چو شب گشاده به نفرین زهاک لب. He wasn't thinking of power anymore. He was just burning with jealousy. به دست اندرش آب گندش نبود. به خون پری چهرگان تشنه بود. He attacked towards them. زبالا چو پی بر زمین برنهاد برآمد فریدون به کردار باد. فریدون hit him on the head with his mace. His helmet broke. He wanted to break his head too, when suddenly بیامد سروش خجست دمان مزن گفت کورا نیامد زمان. So, فریدون tied Zahak with a rope of lion leather. The war is over, people. The dragon was imprisoned, and the black cloud moved away from the city. مهان پیش او خاک دادند بوس، ز درگاه برخاست آوای کوس. People watched their new king leaving the city with Zahak, who was on all fours with his hands tied.
همی راند او را به کوه اندرون، همی خواست کارد سرش را نگون. بیامد همانگه خجسته سروش، به خوبی یکی راز گفتش به گوش.
Don't kill him. Just take him to Damavand Mountain. He did so, and with big and heavy nails, he nailed Zahak between the stones in a narrow valley.
Now, if you're wondering where is Kaveh the blacksmith, the thing is, everyone from those chef brothers to Feridun each gave small blows to the body of that kingdom. Otherwise, it wouldn't break, even with that mace. Some say that Kaveh's name is similar to Gav, which is the Persian word for cow. Feridun was raised by a cow, and we also have the cow-headed mace. These three together triumphed over the three-headed dragon. And why wasn't he killed? Ferdowsi doesn't explain that. But some say if you kill the devil, the world will go out of balance. But look at him now. Isn't it better than death?
فریدون فرخ فرشته نبود. ز مشک و ز انبر سرشته نبود. ز داد و دهش یافت آن نیکوید. تو داد و دهش کن فریدون توی.
And that was it. Thanks for listening. I'm excited to read your comments on this story. I'm Sarah, a daughter of Iran, and I'm happy about it.